Hey guys, it's Lindsay. Welcome back to my channel, and today I've got a quick update for my current project pan. This is my third project pan of 2016, and this is going to be the second update for that project pan. I will go ahead and link to the last update right up there. I just did that a few weeks ago, but if you are curious about how my progress was looking back then, you can go take a look at that video. But let's just dive right in and I'll show you the progress. So as of the last update, I had finished off three products. I had finished off my Malin & Goetz Lip Balm, my Anastasia Brow Wiz, and then I also finished off the Olay Henriksen Pure Truth Melting Cleanser. And then since that last update, I managed to finish off quite a few more. And actually, this one I actually might have considered finished in the last update. It's definitely considered finished now. This is the Olay and CoverGirl Facelift Effect Makeup. This is what it looked like. I don't think I used this again. I know I said in the last update that I was going to try to use it because I really liked mixing this with the other foundation that I had in this product, but I was able to find something else to mix that with. So this one is completely done, and then going along with the foundations, I was able to finish off my Revlon Color Stay. This was in the color Sand Beige, and it was a little bit too dark. That's why I like to mix these two, but I think I mixed this either with my True Match Lumi or just my regular True Match foundation one or two times to get this completely gone, and that was fine. As you can see, I don't have one of those scraper things, but I did my very best to get as much of the product out that I could. So that's what the jar currently looks like, and I'm just going to consider this one completely done. I was also able to finish off my e.l.f. Mineral Mist. I would say this is a product just like the Mario Badescu Rose Water Spray. It was fine, not my favorite product, and I've got quite a few other sprays right now that I need to get through, so I would not repurchase, but I'm very happy that that one is done. And then I finished off two other products. The first one here is my little lip pencil. This one was from Model Co. I believe this is called the Illusion Lip Liner. It wasn't my favorite, and there is a tiny little bit left here, as you can see. If it will focus, there we go, but it just won't sharpen anymore, so I'm going to consider this one done. And then the last product that I managed to finish off since the last update was my powder. This is the Urban Decay D-Slick Powder. I hardly had any left as of the last update, so it probably just took me one, maybe two more times until this was completely finished off, but I did manage to finish this off completely, and I really do like this powder. It's very expensive, and I think the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder works almost as well as this. Not quite, so I'm not going to repurchase this one right now because we are moving into fall, and I don't need such a heavy powder in fall and winter, but I would maybe consider purchasing this again in the summer if I need something really, really mattifying. So then I just have three more products left to work on for this project, and I think I really only have a chance of finishing off one of them, which is my Clinique Super Defense Age Defense Eye Cream. I really don't like this, as you guys know. I've talked about this many times. It just takes forever to rub in, and it leaves this horrible white cast around my eyes, but I have made pretty steady progress on here, as you can see. So I'm all the way down here now, so if I continue to use it, and I have been really good about using this, then I definitely think I could finish this off. If not finish it off completely, I will definitely be very, very close to finishing it off, so I probably wouldn't even put this in another project pan because I know I would finish it anyways, but hopefully I can finish this off by the next update, which will be the finale at the very end of September. So that's that one. And then for the last two products, I don't think there's any way that I'm going to be able to finish them off, but let me show you the progress. The first one here is from Clinique. This is my Chubby Stick in the color Roly Poly Rosy. And I've made pretty steady progress. You aren't going to be able to see that because it's such a shiny cap, but I have been marking my progress, and from month to month it has been very steady progress. So let me go ahead and show you what the product looks like right now. So like I said, I have made some progress. I've probably used close to half of what is here, so maybe not quite, but just about half of what I first started with. So I'm thinking maybe by the next update I will have half of what is left here, and I'll be happy with that, and then I can definitely roll this over to the next project, and I should be able to finish it off rather quickly then, but we shall see. But again, that is what it looks like, and I don't think there's any way that I'm going to finish this off, but I have been using it pretty consistently. I do have it on my cheeks today, and I like this product. I actually didn't think that I really liked cream blushes, but I've actually been using them quite a bit this year, and I don't hate them as much as I thought I did. I think this is actually the last one that I have, because I did finish off another one earlier in the year. I don't need to go out and buy any or anything, but if I got another one in a subscription box or something, I definitely would like to use it. But yeah, so anyways, that is that. And then let me show you the last product. It is from Pixi. This is the Tinted Brilliance Balm in the color Radiant Rose. And again, let me kind of try and show you the progress. Hopefully you can see there. It has been pretty steady over the last couple of months that I've been working on it, but again, there's just too much product left still that I don't think there's any way that I'm going to finish it all up. But that is what it looks like. I would be happy if I got through about a third of that in the next month. I think that's probably going to be on par with how much I've been using of it so far. But of course, it would be really great if I could finish this off. I just don't think there is any way that I will. And I've been going back and forth with this product on if I want to continue this into another project pan or if I want to switch it up and use a different lip balm or lip product that I could potentially finish off by the end of the year. I mean, I think I definitely could finish this by the end of the year, but I'm kind of going to be sick of this, I think, by the end of the next month. I'm kind of sick of this now, to be honest, but I'm continuing to use it. I just don't think there's any way that I will finish it. Even if I use it like 5 times every single day, there's just no way. So that was all my progress for this project pan. And of course, I will come back by the end of next month to do a finale. And then going into October, I will have my last project pan of the year started. But yeah, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. If you're currently working on a project pan, I wish you good luck. Hopefully you can finish every single one of your items. That is always the goal, right? It doesn't usually happen that way, but that is always the goal. And I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of my updates. We can also connect on Instagram. I will have my link listed in the description box below, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!